If you've been using the Linux CLI for a while, you've probably seen a lot of these commands before, but I promise, I'm not just listing commands. In this video, I'll walk you through 10 Linux CLI commands and some surprising ways to use them. And by the end of this video, there's a good chance you will think, wait, you can do that? So let's level up. All right, let's talk grep. Now wait, before you skip this part because it's only grep, I'm going to show you some flags that might make it more interesting, because everybody knows grep, but I rarely see people use it like this. So let's get going. I have a huge log file. And someone logged in and removed the user. But when I grep for it, I only get these two lines. What if I want to see a little bit more context? Turns out grep has a -c flag, where you can specify how many lines you want to see before and after the match. Like this. Now you can see that my match is in the middle, but above it and below it, I see the requests that were done before and after my match. If I want to see the requests only before my match, I can use the -b flag. And if I want to see only the matches after, I can use the -a flag. And then you have awk, and everybody knows that you can pipe stuff to awk and print the columns of the output. This would print the first column. What's lesser known about awk is that it's kind of its own programming language. Let's say, if I want to calculate stuff on the fifth column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this one, I'll cast it to int, and then if it's over 10%, we should print the first column. And we can even print the fifth as well. You could, for example, do stuff like this. Now it feels more like a productivity tool than just a command. Someone has even made a Wolfenstein clone in awk. Isn't that crazy? While he's playing, now's a good time to subscribe and hit that bell icon for notifications. Okay, back to the commands. CP is used to copy files. But let's say that you have a large file, and you want to copy this to a second file. How long will this take? Well, with CP, you don't know. But what if you're on a slow connection and want to know how long it will take? You can use rsync instead. Like this, and you would get a progress bar and a speed and everything just out here, which can be very nice. Okay, so maybe you know your way around man pages, but honestly, I hate scrolling through 900 lines to find a flag that I can't remember. And that's where tldr comes in. Tldr is like man's younger, cooler brother. Often it's a tool that you have to install, but it may just well be worth it. And here you have one-liner examples for the most common tasks that you usually would like to do. Let's see TLDR for CP and even TLDR for find. That's pretty nice. So let's try one of them. Bam. Can't get better than that. And I'll tell you, if I had this in my early days, I think I'd shave years off my learning curve. So the next one is really underrated. Let's say you're doing your normal stuff, just tagging along, and I forgot sudo. Oh, did you know that double exclamation mark? It reruns your last command.
What?
And you can use it as an argument for sudo, for example. And there you go. It has really saved me a lot of keyboard smashes. Talking about keyboard smashes, have you ever been to the Matrix? Isn't that random? And there's even a tool to see the Matrix. It's called C-Matrix. What do you think? What do you think? Okay, so the next tip is, let's say you wrote a long command line yesterday, something with multiple flags and pipes and whatever. And now it's the next day. And you don't remember this command. How do you get it back? With Ctrl+R. It drops you into reverse search. You can type anything you remember from the command, and it searches your history for the command. You can press arrows or end to edit the command. Or if it wasn't the right one, you can press Ctrl+R again to get a previous command. Yeah, that's the one. Once you get used to using this, it will save you tons of time. Have you ever had a list of things that you would like to do something with? For example, this list of URLs that I would like to download. Instead of taking every single link and pasting it into wget, I can use something called xargs. And it will take every link in that output and use it as an argument to wget, one by one. That's what this means, -n1. Right, and if you're really paranoid about what it will do, you can just use echo wget instead, and it will show all the commands that it will be running. That's pretty nice. So on to the next one. You have free, right? But have you ever wanted to run this continuously every second to see what's going on with your system? That's something you can do with watch. This tells watch to run free every second. Here you see I have 4 gigs total, and I've spent about half a gig. Let's see what happens if I spend like half a gig more. I'm going to use stress for this. Let's see what happens. Yeah, there it goes. And you can see it moving in real time. That's pretty neat. And you can use this for commands like for disk space and memory and everything. So that's good. You have probably used cat a million times. But have you seen bat? It's kind of like cat, but with line numbers, syntax highlighting, and Git integration. Just look at this. You get the line numbers, file name, and everything is syntax highlighted. Just seriously, it just makes reading config files and everything so much easier. So if you haven't seen that yet, you should check it out. So let me give you one of the simplest and most satisfying tricks I know. If you're deep in a folder working and you figure, hey, I want to be back where I was before, you can use cd- to switch back to the directory that you were previously in. And yeah. You can switch back and forth all day. That was 10 powerful Linux tricks.